And we're gonna recover. Nose down, full throttle, carpet off, right rudder. Hey everyone, welcome aboard. I'm Thomas, I'm training to be a flight instructor. Teaching for the cameras to get some extra practice while everything is locked down due to the virus. Good news on the lockdown, the hair salons opened back up, so I got a haircut. And today I'm going to teach the stall and how to recover from one. So we're going to actually fly the airplane into a stall, show you what happens, and also show you how to get back out of that and how to safely resume a normal flight. So I'll first go and actually show you one, and then I'll give you a little bit of theory background, and then show you a few more more aggressive ones and a few different ways that it can look. We're just exiting the airspace around Lelystad Airport, where we took this this plane from. So all the background noise on the radio will reduce in a minute, and then we're ready to do some exercises. So to start the exercise, what we need to do is first of all make sure that the aircraft is ready for it. So what we'll do is very similar to the arrival checks to an airport. It works very well in Dutch. Actually, in English it's a little bit more hard, but one of my old flight instructors used to say, try the brakes, belts and bags, which means check the brakes work. Well, I'm not going to use them now, but they're very useful after landing. Everyone has their belts on and all the bags are secured. One trick I usually do is put a belt around the bag. That's what I've done in the back here. So everything is ready to do some air exercises and to do some practice. Then the next step that we're going to do is actually a pre-exercise checklist that I want to do for every exercise where we're starting. So in this case, my school uses APOS, A-P-O-S. Some schools use different ones. It's a personal preference. All of them work as long as you use the same one every time. So what we'll do is APOS, which means we'll check the altitude, so minimum altitude for a full stall, 2,500 feet when solo, which we are today, we are at 2,500 feet. Position, we don't want to do this above built-up areas, open water, clouds, or any of those things. Well, there's nice empty farm fields below me, so that's good. Then orientation, you want to have a good sort of straight lookout. In this case, I would pick something slightly left of the nose, so I can still see it when I'm slowing down. So what I have is a nice little lake over there. And then the last step is sky clear, which means we're going to do a lookout turn to take a quick scan for traffic, because we're going to be maneuvering and doing exercises, and of course we don't want to run into anyone while we do that. Once we've done the sky clear checks, we're going to do the same checks that we do on downwind for landings. That means the fuel selector, magnetos, engine instruments, primer, fuel pump, mixture and carb heat, and then go straight into the stall exercise. And the exercise itself means we go to power idle, we're going to slow down. When you fly this with an instructor, you would normally also brief when you recover. In this case, I'll tell you. And I'm going to do an approach to the stall. So I'm going to recover at the first warning or first indication, which can be 5 knots above the green range on the airspeed indicator, a beep or any buffeting of the aircraft. So first, let's start with the clearing turn. So we're going to look to the right, scan all the way through the sky to see that there's no traffic around us. And we're going to make a 90 degree turn to the left. And while we turn, it's important to also check underneath, especially in a low wing like this. You want to look under the wings to see there's no one flying underneath you. You want to look behind us, because now in the turn we can actually see what is behind us. And once we've turned through roughly 90 degrees, which is right about now, we're going to do the same thing to the right. So we take a final look left here, we look around, we're going to look to the right and do the same thing, such that it's also empty and clear there behind us. And especially now that we have some haziness and some clouds in the distance, it's good for visibility to make these turns and really get to see where everything is. And we're slowly turning, taking a final look, all directions, no one around us, nice and empty. And we're going to do the stall exercise. So, fuel selector to the right, magnetos both, engine instruments in the green, primer locked, fuel pump on, mixture rich, carb heat on, and power idle. And again, we're going to do an approach to the stall. So we're going to keep the aircraft at this altitude by pulling, but with no power. So we want to keep on flying here, keep our lookout point in the distance there to keep the aircraft right, use the feet to keep the ball in the middle, even more important than the stall exercise. You can see me pulling more and more and more. We're coming up on our stall speed. and let it go all the way until the beep, so we're still at altitude. That should go now any minute. Yep, brake over. Nose down, full throttle, car meet off, back up to speed, and get it back out of the dive. And the beeps that we were at 2300 feet, so we lost 200 feet, which is fine. Go back into climb altitude, go back to 2500. We finished our exercise. Okay, so this was an approach to the stall. So we haven't actually stalled the aircraft, we recovered at the beep, so at the stall warning, which actually comes on before it fully stalls. So what I'll do now is, through the magic of editing, show you a little bit of the theory behind it. And then once you've seen that, we're going to make the aircraft do an actual stall. And what you'll see is that it's a lot more violent. You'll see the nose drop, loss of altitude. But I would like to show you the theory first, so that you actually understand what is happening there. So I'll make it appear sort of right here.
So what I have here is a diagram of a wing, with air flowing above and underneath it to help it generate lift. But if I want to generate more lift out of that wing, I can tilt it backwards like this, where I'm increasing the angle of attack, which is the angle between the airflow coming in and the chord line of the wing. And when I do that, I will change the flow pattern, so I'll get more lift, but also some of that air will no longer nicely follow the wing. And I'll get this gray area where the air is just sort of swirling around. Now, if I take this to an extreme and keep on increasing the angle of attack of that wing, then I'll start losing more and more of that nice airflow over the wing. And a stall is really the situation where I've taken it so far that increasing the angle of attack doesn't get me more lift, but actually makes me lose almost all the lift from the wing, and therefore make it stop flying.
So the difference between an approach to the stall and the full stall is really the moment we recover. The aircraft is doing the same thing, but in a full stall, what I'm going to do is ignore the beeping of the stall warning and really let it stall. And what you'll see is that it's actually not easy to stall a training aircraft like this. Well, it's an easy exercise, but it's not not easy to get it wrong. It will almost fix this by itself. So we are again after the last exercises. Altitude 2500, position above nice farmland, orientation, the water there in the distance, and I actually have a heading set of 180 as well. And the sky clear, we've checked. What we're going to do is do a quick 90 degree turn over here to check underneath and behind us. And that's 90 degrees, and then we're going to take a look on the right side. Quickly scan also the area that we're going to fly into, because that's where we might meet some traffic while we do this. Take a good look, everything clear, no other traffic. Back on the heading, back towards the same bridge that we were flying to. Ready to do the stall. So, fuel select to the right, needles to both, engines are in the green. Primer locked, fuel pump on, mixture rich, carb heat on, and we are ready to go. We'll go power idle, direction with the feet, because any power change requires also using the rudder. And we'll keep that bridge that I have, well I can see it, probably you can't, next to the nose, and I'll start pulling. You'll see the speed decreasing and decreasing, and I keep more and more the pressure coming up to keep the altitude. And we're still slowing down, and I'm still adding more and more pressure. There's actually, you can't see it, but there's a lot of thing I need to do to get us here. And we're gonna get the stall warning soon. I'm going to ignore it because I want a full stall. There it is. I'm gonna keep on pulling because I really wanted to stall, right? And now I'm actually at the maximum. Pull, can't get any back. The aircraft is shaking and shaking, and it's wanting to drop the nose. You can see it. Now this is a full stall, so I'm gonna recover. Nose down, full throttle, carb heat off, and wait for it to be back at flying speed. And then we take it out of the dive. And what you see here, we've lost about 500 feet, which is pretty normal in a recovery, and it's fine, right? Because you want to aggressively push the nose forward. It's not a game where you want to keep the altitude loss to a minimum. It's really important that you break the stall and get the aircraft back to flying normally. So losing a couple hundred feet is perfectly fine because it means you did a good recovery from the actual stall. So, back at 2500, we let it accelerate again to the normal speed. We're going to finish these exercises by doing the after exercise checklist. So we're going to check again. Is power set for cruise? There we go. Switch fuel tanks. So in this case, I'm going to go back to my left tank. That's the one I want to fly on now. Check our orientation. Where are we? Are all the instruments in the green? Is the engine happy? Fuel pump can be turned off. The carbine is already off. Turn it off at the recovery. Clean the mixture back to normal, and we're back in cruise flight. So that's it for the lesson on stalls. One extra disclaimer, do not ever try to do this alone without having an instructor told you that you're good to do it. There's nothing wrong, there's nothing dangerous about doing this with an instructor, but it is a maneuver you should do well, because if you get it wrong, it can get dangerous. If this lesson has inspired you to try and want to try it yourself, send me an email, thomas@fromthehangar.com, and I'll try to hook you up with a trial lesson so you can actually experience this all by yourself. For now, thank you for watching. If you liked it, like, subscribe, you know the buttons underneath the screen. Thank you, bye! Okay.